MrExcel podcast is sponsored by MrExcel. Excel VBA Chapter 15, Marking Duplicates. Well, hey, welcome back to the MrExcel Netcast. I'm Bill Jellin. In Excel 2007, they added these new conditional formatting rules, including something called duplicate values. And I was pretty excited about this when I saw it because they offer the chance to mark either duplicates or uniques. But, you know, in my humble opinion, they got this wrong. They didn't do what was really useful. So here's what would happen if you chose duplicates. And you'll see that 17 is selected because 17 appears two times. And 11 is highlighted because 11 appears two times. And let's take a look at the unique values over in column C. And you see that it's the opposite. What they're saying is, hey, 12 is being highlighted here as unique because it only occurs one time in the list. But to me, this is not really the list of unique values. What we really want for unique values is we want the first 17, the first 11, the first 7, but not the second 7. And neither of those built-in items will do what we want. And what we really want is what I call wishful thinking over here. I have a little macro to do that. In wishful, the first 17 is highlighted because that is a unique value, that 17. The second 17 isn't because it's a repeat, 11, 7, and so on. And so in this case, the red cells are the complete list of truly every value occurring once, which I think is really what we need. Now, to do this is much harder than just choosing duplicates. We have to use a formula version, so we say use a formula to determine which cells to format. That formula has to be written relative to the first active cell, so in this range E2 is the first active cell, and we say, hey, always go from E2 down to the current cell, see if it's equal to the current cell, and if that COUNTIF is 1, then this is the first time that's occurred. All right, now let's take a look at how to do that in VBA. We'll switch over to VBA here, and we'll take a look at the code. So, whereas the first two were pretty easy here, just using dupe unique equal to XL duplicates or dupe unique equal to XL unique, to do the one that I think is actually useful, we have to do where we're adding a condition as an expression, and then pass an argument of formula 1. That formula has to be the same formula that we'd set up. So again, relative to the very first cell here, E2, this formula has to refer to a formula that will work in E2. Now they'll replicate it, and because I used a clever use of dollar signs here and no dollar signs, it will change as we go down through the various cells. But to set this up in VBA, certainly a little bit easier perhaps than figuring out every time to get that in there as a macro. It would really be nice if Microsoft would offer this as one of those choices. You know, I don't know what they would call it. Maybe they'd call it Bill Jellin unique or something like that. You know, who knows? So useful unique, or I don't know. I mean, but you get the point here. We're trying to get a list of every item, but only one of every item. So, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.